Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I am feeling particularly grateful today for the great community we have here on YouTube because you folks are recommending some great demos for me to share with you. Case in point, our friend John Marshall, when he was watching a video that we did on Scannable, the Evernote scanning app, recommended that I take a look at SnapEntry. I guess you could also pronounce it SnapEntry, but it seems to me it should be SnapEntry. Doesn't it seem that way to you? Indeed. At any rate, John said that he thought that we, community, might enjoy a demo on SnapEntry. So I took a quick look at it, liked it, put it on the roster, and now I'm sharing with you SnapEntry today on Dotto Tech. So this is fantastic, having people in the community recommending demos, and I love it. So if you have great ideas of products that you want to share and want to see more, please share them with us here on the YouTube channel. I can't promise that I have time or the ability to demonstrate every product, but I look at each and every one, and indeed I do consider each one as we go along. So let's take a look right now at SnapEntry. Now, what is SnapEntry? It's a very simple little tool that allows us to quickly create notes and share them to Evernote. Now, you might have a little bit of confusion as to where the value lies in a tool that allows you to create a note in Evernote and then export it to Evernote, because you're saying to yourself, I know, Steve, don't quite understand. Why don't I just create the note in Evernote? Well, I will tell you why. And this isn't for everybody, but if I'm describing something that is an issue for you, then a tool like SnapEntry indeed becomes valuable. So if I'm creating notes, I'm always in a hurry, it seems, when I'm creating a note. I want to do it the most quick and efficient way. And the challenge with creating a note in the Evernote mobile apps is it's a very rich environment. There's a lot of moving parts in our app, so that it takes a few clicks to navigate through. And sometimes it even takes one, oh, where am I? And wondering to go back and forth before you can indeed create a new note. If that doesn't bother you, if it's never been an issue for you and you never feel like you would like to find a faster method for entering the note, then just enter notes natively in Evernote and you are in great shape. If you're in a bit more of a hurry and you think $2.99 might be worthwhile spending, I think it's $2.99, yeah, $2.29 might be worth spending in order to have quicker access, then SnapEntry might be for you. Now, so what SnapEntry does is it really streamlines the entire note-taking process. So I'm going to open SnapEntry, and what it does is it brings us up our keyboard, and you can use any of your installed keyboards will work in SnapEntry, but the main thing is this little bar that we see here above the keyboard. This gives us quick access to a lot of the formatting and different features within Evernote. Let me just paste in a note that I've already created. So this is a to-do list or a checklist for I'm going to San Diego next week. So these are things that I might want to do. So using the different tools at the bottom, I can make things into a checklist item. I can turn other items into bullet points should I choose to. If I want to, I can take the entire note, and by hitting on the little reminder icon, I can issue a reminder to myself. Now, this is going to use Evernote's built-in native reminders. All of these different formatting things that we're adding to this note will apply in Evernote directly. So I can make a reminder out of this as well, just by hitting the checkpoint there. If I choose to, I can also go and I can put in the time and date of the note, which is ideal if you're using it for journaling and that sort of stuff, or you want to take notes of when your note is taken. And then it also extends the functionality quite a bit by allowing us to access the camera within our smartphone and be able to take pictures of items and include them in the note as well. Once the note is completely formatted and ready to go, we hit that little airplane icon, kind of the paper airplane, and that then syncs it directly to Evernote. It's a very seamless and quick service. But before I show you that, I'm going to show you one last feature, is they've added some extra gestures. With my finger, if I swipe from the left to the right, it will bring out all of my different notebooks because it's synced and it's connected to my Evernote account. So I can choose to save any of these notes that I'm creating directly into the appropriate notebook. And if I go in the opposite direction, it brings out all of my tags so that I can apply all of my tags. It's a very rich kind of mini Evernote environment where you can create a note, apply all of the different formatting and different communication options to that note that we would be interested in doing, but it does it all from a very simple interface. Once that's all said and done, you just hit send and now it syncs through to Evernote. Now, it'll take a second to go through it all, but I'll go into Evernote and show you just to prove to you that indeed it did work. So we'll go into Evernote. We'll let Evernote sync up. We'll go in and view all of our notes, and there's our to-do list for San Diego that we just created and synced through. So we see it has come through effortlessly. Not for everybody. As I say, if it doesn't bother you going through and navigating through Evernote itself to create your note, then there's very little value in a tool like SnapEntry. However, if you think that it would be really convenient to be able to quickly create notes on the fly using the different keyboard, so I could done voice dictation if I chose to, or if I wanted to use the Ginger keyboard, using any of the other keyboards and any of the other input options that we have, if you would want to be able to do that very quickly and sync it to Evernote with that simple service, then $229 might be a bargain indeed. I hope you found today's video to be useful, and special thanks to John for recommending it. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is, of course, subscribe to this channel. The second is you can subscribe to our newsletter, in which case you will be informed of all of our upcoming live events and webinars. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We're supported through you, our patrons, through the crowdfunding site Patreon. If you'd like to know what's involved in supporting Dotto Tech and the benefits that you receive as a patron, please drop by our Patreon page and have a look. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.